Sri Krishna at Kaalindi. Parikshit inquired sage Shuka, hearing the stories of the Lord who condescended to tend the cattle of Nanda in the village of Brindavan is really strange and interesting. It's indeed a wonder. Even lunatics will not feel contented of hearing them, but would be asking for more. Please continue the narration. How did Sri Krishna make the poisonous waters of Kaalindi safe for human consumption? How did he drive away the serpent Kaliya? Why and how long was that serpent living in the deep lake? In reply, sage Shuka narrated to Parikshit the story of the snake Kaliya. There was a deep lake by the name of Kaalindi, fed by the river Yamuna. Sage Saubari was performing tapas on its bank. Once the sage noticed that all the fish in the lake were moaning. He came to know that Garuda, the king of birds and the celestial conveyance vehicle of Lord Vishnu, was eating away all the fish. Out of compassion for the fish, the sage commanded that if Garuda were to peep and show his head anywhere near the lake thereafter, he would fall down dead. On hearing this command, Garuda stopped going that side for fear of death. The cruel serpent Kaliya had heard this verdict of the sage. It was customary in olden days for all people who were afraid of serpents to make a feast every month and offer plenty of sweets and eatables to the serpents and leave them at the foot of a special peepal tree and go away. The serpents would all join together, gather all the offerings, set apart a good portion of it to Garuda, their enemy, so that he might not harm them, and eat the rest to their heart's content. This custom continued for a long time. The serpent Kaliya was full of vigor with plenty of deadly poison. One day he went and ate away completely the portion left separately by the snakes for Garuda and ran away. Garuda was deprived of his customary food. He heard of the mischief of Kaliya. He chased him, tore his hoods into pieces and otherwise wounded him in many ways. The serpent got afraid and ran for life and hid himself and took asylum in the tank called Kaalindi. There he was safe from the attacks of Garuda. But on account of the deadly poison that he possessed, the water there became poisonous for all men, animals and birds. On account of the deadly poison, the water in the lake was always in a state of boiling heat. Even birds, if they were to fly over the lake, would fall down dead. The breeze from the lake too was poisonous to living creatures. Sri Krishna heard this and wanted to purify the water and make it useful for all living creatures. One day Sri Krishna went to the pasture land with the cattle, leaving Balarama at home. It was a very hot day in summer. The cattle and the cowherd boys were unable to bear the thirst. They went in haste and drank the water of the lake Kaalindi, and all of them lay down dead on the bank. Sri Krishna witnessed this with great pity. He looked at them and by the grace of his very look, all of them got up with life. They knew full well that they got back their lives only due to Sri Krishna. Sri Krishna proceeded with his plan already decided upon by him. On the bank of the lake, he saw a kadamba tree. It had its branches extending over the lake. He got up the tree, he tied his loincloth tight round his hips, moved his tuft of hair up to the center of the head and reached a distant branch overhanging the water. He clapped his hands and took one leap into the tank. The water began to rise up to a great height by the splash and it overflowed the banks. Then Sri Krishna began to swim in the water, exhibiting his great strength of arms and made the water tumultuous. The serpent Kaliya was inside the water. He thought that a daring and mischievous boy not knowing his powers, had entered the water and was making the disturbance. He wanted to teach the boy a lesson. He came out and bit the blue boy of Brindavan with his poisonous fangs. Not satisfied with that, he twisted himself tight round his legs. The cowherd boys standing on the bank, who saw the condition of Sri Krishna, were stunned, afraid, and were unable to do anything. They began to weep. The cows and the calves were staring at Sri Krishna like statues and would not move or graze. By the time the village folk at Brindavan had many indications of evil portents, they decided that some harm must have happened to Sri Krishna. All the elders started out, including Yashoda and the other ladies. Balarama saw their distress, their pitiable condition and their anxiety, but did not interfere, even though he knew the greatness of Sri Krishna. Silently he followed them. All of them together marched on, tracing the footprints of the cows, calves and that of Sri Krishna, and reached the tank Kaalindi. There, to their horror, they saw in the middle of the waters Sri Krishna bitten and twisted round tight by the most poisonous serpent, Kaliya. Sri Krishna was not struggling or moving. The cowherd boys on the bank were piteously crying for help, and the cattle were standing stunned without grazing the green grass before them. Nanda and Yashoda were shocked. They decided that the venom had spread all over the body of Sri Krishna and that there was no more hope of rescue. They thought that life without Sri Krishna was useless and determined to end their lives along with him. Balarama was standing by their side. He requested them to have some patience and witness the further developments with courage. Slowly, Sri Krishna opened his eyes. He began to move his body. He expanded his body. The serpent could no longer have a grip on him. It stopped biting him, left off his body and stood at a distance. Sri Krishna caught hold of his head tight, took him off the waters, swung him round and round like a rope and threw him off. The serpent regained control of his own body and stood with his hood up. Sri Krishna stepped on to the hoods and began to dance with step, tilt and tune to the accompaniment of the background music from the tumultuous tank waters. He began to jump and do all sorts of acrobatic feats as if it were a stage. Gods and celestials had by then assembled in the sky to witness this transcendental performance with awe and admiration, which they never witnessed before. They rained flowers on Sri Krishna. Meanwhile, the serpent was exhausted and began to vomit blood from its mouth. He realized the danger ahead waiting for him and began to think within himself, even gods would die by the mere touch of my poison. This little boy does not seem to feel anything out of it, even after all my bites. This must be the Supreme Lord come here in the form of a young boy. My pride is in vain. I must surrender myself to him. The wives of the serpent Kaliya came out of the water and began to praise Sri Krishna. O Lord, we know that you are born on this earth to punish the wicked, and therefore your actions cannot be called cruel. It's only kindness. You love even your enemies. You have no enmity. You eliminate the evil in order to bestow happiness for the good of the world. If you punish such cruel people like us, it is only your grace. This serpent should have acquired great merit, punya, in his previous births to have the fortune of being touched by your sacred feet. Because even after strenuous tapas, sages are not able to see you, much less obtain the touch of your lotus feet. O Lord, because you pervade every living body, you are called Purusha. You have no divisions. So you are one and great, Ekam, Mahat. The five elements function because of you. So you are Antaryamin. You are causeless. So you are Paramatman. You are beyond knowledge and ignorance and the three gunas. And so you are Brahman. You are the Lord of Prakriti. So you are powerful. You are master of time. So you are called Kala. You are beyond birth, existence and death. And so you are called witness, Sakshi. We prostrate to you. You are the universe. You are a witness in the universe. You are the cause of the universe. You are the lord of all the five elements, the indriyas, prana, mind and intellect. You command the three gunas and you are not deceived by these three masks. You are infinite and imperceptible. You are subtle and without qualities. You are the permanent abode for everything. We salute you. O Lord, out of ignorance, people say that you exist. You exist not. You are all. You are small. You are bound. You are liberated. You are one. You are many with so many arguments. All these apply to you and more too. You are all names and yet you have no name. You are perceived as different manifestations by the different sense perceptions. You are knowledge itself. So you are called Kavi. You are the storehouse of the Vedas. You are the protector of your devotees and you reward them. You are invisible and unknown. You are the cause of all actions and so Hrishikesha. You are beyond approach by any sadhana. You are self-revealing. Atma Ram, you are Muni. You are witness for the gross and subtle actions in the Jiva. You are the cause of knowledge and ignorance. We salute you. This serpent is a cruel one. He had done great crimes. He had done harm to you. We do not plead ignorance on his part. But please give us the charity of a husband. This grace we beg of you. Please stop your celestial dance. He is exhausted. His actions have slowed down. His breath is stopping. He is swooning. Please spare his life for our sake. Acceding to their humble appeal, Sri Krishna stopped his transcendental dance and came out of the water. The serpent Kaliya slowly regained his consciousness and vigor and stood up. He thanked the Lord for giving him due punishment and for the grace of sparing his life. He said further, I have obtained the greatest profit in having been touched by your sacred feet, while great sages are still struggling to obtain the dust of your lotus feet. What more do I want? You may give me any punishment. I am not worried. My goal of life is fulfilled. Hearing his grateful words, the Lord ordered him to vacate the tank along with his family and proceed to and live in the ocean. You need not have fear of Garuda hereafter. Because of my footprints on your head, he would not touch you. This tank will be a holy place for posterity, said the Lord. The serpent Kaliya adorned the Lord with many clothes, necklaces and precious garlands. Saluted him and left for the ocean, which is otherwise called Ratnakara. Sri Krishna came and joined the cowherd folk. Nanda, Yashoda and Rohini regained their consciousness from swoon and there was no limit for their joy on seeing Sri Krishna amidst them. Balarama embraced his brother. The cows and calves began to cry loudly and jump and run about in their ecstasy. Yashoda took Sri Krishna into her lap and kissed him. Having been exhausted by the incident, all of them slept on the banks of Kaalindi for the night. At midnight, a forest fire surrounded them. They began to cry and pray to Sri Krishna for protection. He extinguished the fire by swallowing it up as if it were like drinking water. Next morning, all of them returned to Vrindavan.